Have you ever had an experience that was so good, so epic, so incredible? Like an experience that was just so amazing that you had difficulty trying to explain it to other people? Maybe you had an experience like this when you had the opportunity to travel someplace beautiful in the world. Maybe you felt this way after eating the best pizza of your life. You told your friends, but no matter how you described it, the doughy crust and the melted cheese and the perfectly placed ham and pineapple, yeah, I said it. It just couldn't capture it. And you found yourself saying something like, you just have to go and taste it for yourself. Or maybe you felt that way about a concert you went to and your friends are like, oh yeah, I saw the concert when they made it a documentary on Netflix. So I totally understand what it was like. But you're like, dude, you have no idea. You could feel the music in your chest and the crowd was crazy. And there was just this electricity in the air. And even though you tried to capture it on a video from your phone, it just wasn't the same. So you just end up saying, you gotta go and see it for yourself. Or maybe it was a time you had with your friends. You know, the ones where it's just the kind of night where you didn't like do anything crazy, but the vibe was just right. And you laughed until you hurt, but things also got deep. Those nights, those are the ones you remember forever. But then you got home and your parents said, hey, like, what did you do tonight? And words just didn't make sense. Or they asked, what'd you guys talk about? And all you could think was, no matter what I say, it's not gonna make sense to you. You had to be there. For me, I remember taking a trip to the mountains several years ago to a camp. And this wasn't a camping trip to the mountains where there happened to be civilization nearby. There was no 7-Eleven to walk to in a snack crisis to get some hot Cheetos. No, we were hundreds of miles away from any nearby city or town. There were no roads, no cars, no city or streetlights for miles and miles. This was as remote of a spot that I had ever been like in my life. And I remember the first night sleeping outside and I looked up into the night sky and I saw the Milky Way galaxy spread out as far as I could see. I'd never seen it before. It was beautiful. It was crystal clear and it took up the entire night sky. I hardly slept that night because I couldn't stop staring into this group of stars that are apparently always there, but I'd never been able to see them. I remember trying to explain to other people what it looked like to see it, what it felt like to see hundreds of millions of stars in one moment. It felt then kind of like it feels now, like I just can't do it. All I could say then is what I have to tell you now. At some point, you need to find a way to go and see it for yourself. Some things in life just can't be explained. They need to be experienced. During the Christmas season, it's almost impossible to not hear about the birth of Jesus. And yes, you'll hear plenty about Santa Claus and reindeer, endure Christmas movie marathons, complete the usual Christmas traditions, but the foundational message of Christmas is about how God came to earth as a helpless baby. And even if you aren't a church person or you aren't really sure about what you believe about the whole story, the message of the birth of Jesus is kind of impossible to avoid this time of year. You can't go very long without seeing a nativity scene, a manger, angels, lights, all of it trying to explain how incredible the meaning of the season is. Maybe you've noticed church people get super into it. Maybe you've heard people try and explain to you that because of the birth of Jesus, you can know how incredible God is. Because of Christmas, you can know how powerful God is. Because of this season, and because God came down to earth, you can know how loving God is. And you hear all the explanations and all of the reasons, but for you, you just aren't sure you really get it. And to be honest, there's some really good reasons you might not get it. One reason you might not get it or believe it is because of the type of people who are telling you the story. Maybe you've heard about how life-changing the birth of Jesus is from people whose lives don't look very life-changed. Maybe the people who believe the story don't seem to treat other people all that well, and they're super judgmental toward others. And it makes you think, wait, if believing in the story doesn't change how you live, why would I believe it? It doesn't make the story very credible. Or maybe you've heard the story of Jesus' birth explained and how it communicates how good God is. But you look around at the circumstances of your life and it doesn't seem that God is very good. Because, spoiler alert, Life is hard. Maybe it hasn't turned out the way you hoped it would or the way you feel like you deserved. This has been such a difficult year for so many people all around the entire world. You look at how many people lost their jobs, maybe people you know lost their lives or who lost loved ones, and it can be tough to believe in the explanation that there's a good and loving God in control of it all. And maybe that's your story today. Life has just hit you hard, and listening to the explanation of God demonstrating his closeness and goodness to you by coming in the form of a baby just doesn't add up. No matter what you've heard before, whether you care or don't, whether you believe or not, I'm asking you for the next 10 minutes to allow yourself to rethink all of this. And here's why. This isn't a story. Guys, this is history. These were real people with real lives who had real problems and real fears. These were people who had doubts and questions about who God was and how God worked in the world. And the people in this story are people who were not expecting anything particularly special or unique to happen to them. They weren't expecting God to show up on this particular night in history, but he did. So as you listen to this, think about yourself. Put yourself in this story. How would you have responded? What would you have thought? What would you have done? The story starts this way. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. Time out. Let me ask you this. If you were God of the entire universe and you wanted to show up on earth and announce your presence to the world for the first time, how would you do it? My guess is we would at least show up dressed. We would at least show up and make sure we weren't in a position to be hurt or humiliated. We don't even show up at our friend's house without a shower and looking nice, hopefully. But when the God of the universe made his arrival, he picked showing up as a baby. Naked, small, helpless, and completely dependent on others for his survival. That was how God showed up in the world. For almost all of human history, people thought God was angry and distant and someone that had to be appeased. But then God actually showed up in our world as an infant to show that he was humble and kind. And he showed up to let us know that he really does get us and understand us. God showed up in the world just like you showed up in the world. God himself experienced what it was like to be human, what it was like to be you. The Christmas story is a remarkable picture of what God is like. God wanted to put himself in your shoes, wrap himself in skin like you, and experience all the feelings you have felt. In his life, Jesus would experience betrayal, he would get frustrated, he would see one of his best friends die. Guys, Jesus would know what it was like to be rejected by others. He would also know what it was like to have a close-knit group of friends. He would experience the joys of the world around him, and he knew how to throw a party. If you ever wonder if God knows you and if God loves you, if you've ever wondered if God understands you, and if you've ever wondered if God knows what it's like to live on this planet, he does. The Christmas story is proof. The gospel writer Luke goes on, "And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.' Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." Good news of great joy. I love that phrase. I don't know what you've heard about God before, but if what you've heard doesn't sound or look like good news of great joy for all people, then my guess is what you've heard is just wrong. Because the message that God brings to us this time of year is exactly what the angel said it was. It's good news, great joy for everyone. And by showing up and making this announcement to a group of shepherds outside the walls of the city, God could not have been making his point more clear. God's love is for all the people at all times and in all places. See, the shepherds were the lowest of the low when it came to social status. That's why they were outside in the fields. Shepherds were kept away from normal people. They were too poor, too unshowered, too undignified for regular society. That's who God chooses to show up to. Go find the person in your school no one wants to sit with or be around. That's who God would choose to eat lunch with if he showed up to your school. You can't explain a God like that. Like, it's literally unexplainable that he loves all of us and has experienced exactly what it was like to be us. The reason I believe the Christmas story is true, nobody could make this up. Like, people would never make up a story that has God showing up like this because no one would believe it. So when the angels deliver a message like this to a group of people like the shepherds, they have to go and experience Jesus for themselves. If God has done this, if God is like this, if God has showed up to us, then they have to go. And so the shepherds looked at one another and said, "Let's go and see this thing that has happened. Let's experience God for ourselves." And they did, and it changed them forever. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Now, I don't know how you feel about what you heard today. Maybe you believe it all. Maybe you believe none of it. Maybe you feel something, or maybe you feel nothing. No matter where you land, I want to encourage you to do something nobody would have expected in the first century, to follow the examples of the shepherds. Do what they did. Go see for yourself. Sometimes we need to simply go and see for ourselves. We can't let somebody else's experiences tell us what to believe. We need to experience it for ourselves. And how do you do that? How can you continue to experience Jesus in this season? First, keep showing up. Maybe it's your church Christmas services, the series you're starting in January, New Year's Eve party, whatever is happening next at your church, the invite is there to come and see for yourself by showing up to the next big thing your church has. There's power in simply showing up. Second, ask a question. What is it you're wondering about? What is it that makes this all hard to believe? What do you want to know more about? What do you wonder about? Ask someone, a pastor, a parent, a trusted friend who believes. Have a conversation to keep exploring, learning, discovering, and just seeing for yourself. Now, maybe this is the first time you feel like you're seeing for yourself, the first time you're hearing and believing for yourself. And if that's you, continue that conversation with someone. I want you to know and experience the love of Jesus. I want you to experience it for yourself and then think for yourself and then decide for yourself if Jesus is who he says he is. What if you did those things? Like, just imagine if you kept showing up and you experienced something for yourself. What if instead of taking my word for it, or your grandma's word for it, or a pastor's word for it, you just experienced for yourself? How might this next year be different if you did this? As you head out, Be thinking about ways you can be encouraged and encourage those around you to go and see for yourselves. You never know what you might experience. It could change everything.